tellurium is quite a nice element here. I shall pick it up carefully.
Tellurium.
You've never had anything to do with this?
Nothing to do with it in my life. So this is a new one for me. This is tellurium powder. So let's see what's inside the vial. So we open it and tap out the glass vial. This one's going to be stubborn.
This bell shaped here is a sample of tellurium. The reason... Shall I hold it for you?
Yes.
So a sample of tellurium.
Yeah.
I'm slightly cagey about touching this because, as I think I explained with selenium, that if you ingest tellurium into the body, it can get into your sweat and make you smell enough to really drive people mad. And these crystals, like this one, can be cut up and mounted into a piece of apparatus like this.
So a chemist won't deal with all the elements on the periodic table in his career normally?
No, no. Very few chemists will deal with more than perhaps a handful of different elements. So this is the tellurium, and this is, again, this is very high standard material. 3 grams of the tellurium material, and you can see it's a very dark powder at the bottom of the vial.
It was used in this piece of apparatus to shine in an infrared laser, that's like a heat ray, at one frequency, and it came out as twice the frequency, so you can use it to change the effect of the lasers. Unfortunately, the guy doing it didn't make a very good job of it, and you can see he's completely burnt the surface of this piece of tellurium. So the main use of tellurium is as components like this for laser optics, and it's not widely used in chemical industry or similar areas.